Hey YouTube, what's going on? Mark here. Happy Sunday, and most important of all, happy Spurs game day. This is only my second Spurs game of the season, and it's going to be my first full one of the season, considering if y'all remember, even though I never put this on YouTube, I did watch the season opener, which was Wemby's debut, but if y'all recall on Instagram, I couldn't stay up for the whole thing. I had to get my ass to bed for work in the morning, considering how early I start each and every day. While the tradition continues, it's the annual Spurs Cavs game here in Ohio, and we're going to do the version down in San Antonio in a few weeks, February 2nd to the 4th, and therefore I did talk to this man right here, so therefore everything's under control, so the haircut's the 27th, and then, you know, San Antonio the 3rd, and then I'm going to let Christina know that February 10th to rescheduling works perfectly, because we were supposed to go to his son Jason's basketball game yesterday, but those plans went right down the toilet for, you know, other reasons, so, but I got it all figured out, no problem. I will address the still remaining, you know, YouTube schedule for the foreseeable future of season 3 of Winter Wonderland at the end of the video, so I will meet you guys I'll meet you guys at the arena as soon as we, you know, get there.
You're listening to Cleveland After Dark on 107.3 WNWV Elyria, Cleveland.
All right, so therefore we made it to the arena, and so therefore we're about to head into head onto the elevator so they can make our way to where we need to go. Is this thing rolling? Yeah. Okay. So look at this. Look at where my dad decided to bring us to, like, kill time until the doors open. I'll even show you, since this is a better camera than my phone. Look at this view. Look at that view. Wow. So, therefore, we're going to have a Coke, no ice. We're probably going to have something to munch on. Oh, Duncan on the secret. They have a college basketball game here on the opposite end of where I'm sitting. And they're talking, you know, most double-doubles in ACC history. And Wake Forest is, and Tim Duncan is 87. You know, 87 double-doubles. And, wow. So, I was going to say, there's a lot of Spurs jerseys here because, you know, Wembanyama, as we all know, is a big deal. So something tells me for the first time since the 2018-2019 season, the Spurs are going to bring the fight to the Cavs, considering in 2019, actually, no, my math is way off. I mean, for the first time, I forgot about the pandemic game. I forgot about the pandemic game with the limited amount of fans, including my dad and I. We 2018-2019 was the last non-COVID year we won, but the last year we won, period, so, you know, which dates back to when COVID was a big deal. I mean, in 2021 it was still a big deal, but not as big of a deal as it was the year before. So yeah, I forgot. We did win in 2020-2021 when because when the tradition almost you know, the tradition, the cycle of tradition almost broke because the game was postponed after the Spurs Hornets game, which was my birthday Eve game during the rain delay of the Daytona 500. And luckily, they moved it to a good day where we were still able to go. We were still able to go because if they would have held it the original date, then we wouldn't have been able to go. There wouldn't have a lot of fans. But luckily, when they rescheduled, they allowed a limited amount of fans. We were lucky to sneak in the tickets, and that one we did win. So we're looking to bring the fight to the Cavs for the first time since the 2020-2021 season when it was the COVID year with little to no fans in the stands. So therefore, because 21-22 we did lose, which I think was Kelly Berglund's birthday, part three of the Kelly Berglund birthday miracle. And of course, we all know last year, which was the only Spurs content I brought to you guys last year, when we met Beth Regali, was, you know, where of course we got our shit kicked in like Ricky Red, which is no surprise there. Well, what do you know? Look at that. The door. It's open. We're free. I don't know how to fucking zoom in on this thing. All right, I figured out how to zoom in on this thing. I think I see Wembanyama over there. Right, my pointing skills are awful. Right there, the tall guy with the hand on the knee. Yep, that's him. And look at how close we are, period. Let me zoom that out. Yeah, we'll have to see them in San Antonio. I'm going to give you a little view of where we're at. Oh, shit. This is just like last year and the year before. Last year when it was my Kevin Harvick 29th birthday, and the year before, part three of the Kelly Berglund birthday miracle. You gotta be kidding me, look at this.
Yeah.
Oh, hands wrong button. Yeah, no Zach today. Yeah, sorry for the shit quality. Oh well. Here we go, guys. Go Spurs, go! Viva la vida roca! Out. Hell yes! Really a champagne? Oh my god, the quality sucks. Wembanyama! Go Spurs, go! Damn it! And one! Yeah! That's not us. The one-handed free throw, which is what worked for me in the first basketball game of the season. Oh, that worked! Hell yeah! Hell yes! What was that? Is that being reckless? Yeah! Trey Dubs. Get me from a baby. Oh, shoot the first one! Oh, bang, bang, Tito Puente! Again! Bang, bang, Tito Puente! I gotta miss a few positions because I'm trying to like schedule some link-ups with real life friends. Oh, come on! Between real life friends and internet friends, I've been busy on the phone scheduling link-ups. That's why I wasn't able to play the last few Spurs positions. But we're still whooping some ass. At least with this MIU lead, so it's better than... Yeah! Look at that sky! Hell yeah! Uh-oh! Oh, man! Yeah, man. Bang! Bang! Tito Puente! Go! 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 Ale! 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 Three! Oh, not this time! Yeah, man.
Now we decide to thank you, George, again. This first team called the Berea Game.
That's what I'm talking about.
Back in the first
team, Lake Westland.
Yeah.
Damn it!
Yeah, you missed the first quarter.
I know. I feel bad to be barking. Like,
that sucks. I feel bad.
Oh, dude, I had a bunch of fights. And then we have $20 in the bank. Like, hey, no, you can't. I can't do it, bro. You gotta get out of here.
I feel bad for you.
Man, I've been like 15, 20 minutes looking for. Wimby, you're not a good free throw shooter.
People said the same about Duncan years ago.
Wimby's a beast, though.
Yeah.
Dude, every time he goes up against one of these superstar players, big men, he always performs.
Yeah, he does.
Always performs, bro. It's crazy.
So far, gonna be so great.
Yeah,
I hope he does. Spurs fan or not.
I love them. I take them for the first because LeBron's my favorite player.
Right.
Like, you can't deny what he's doing. Even though they're not
working. Right. Knock his ass to the floor. And then we throw the shit away. We throw the shit away. Yeah, of course we do. Okay. I missed quite a bit of footage. Uh-oh, call the po-po.
It says it up there.
Oh, well. That shit takes time. Oh, there it goes.
No, no, two, four, seven.
He's got a long way to go. Hang in there. Oh, shit. Oh, damn.
29%. Let's go!
Might as well catch this one while we're at it. That's all, oh shit. Bang! Bang! Tito Puente! It's a dunk 3-point contest in this bitch.
Okay, Wimby, that's all. You can't shoot three.
Bang! Bang! Tito Puente! Oh my god!
Yeah, he can't do it. He's not doing it, bro. The one thing I say about it, he's not going out of the pool of that shit in here, bro.
Why should he?
I'm just saying he's not. And I feel like he's gonna get stronger like Giannis did. He's already better than Giannis in the rookie.
Right.
Like, way better. So if he's put on like 25, he doesn't need to be like 260. He's like,
no, that's how heavy Duncan was. Robinson was 250.
Yeah, he's like 230, 240. With his skill level, he continues to get better, like,
skill, fundamentals, and he's kept you to win.
Oh, shit. That one's on. Oh, offensive rebound. Oh, shit. Oh, I have to say, oh, shit, every time they launch it. What was that? I think that was a foul.
Jay Allen was on the fucking entire court.
Okay, I had to change the battery because the other one was about to die. So once this one's to go get slow and starts to die, I'm gonna switch to the phone and record the rest of the game there. Oh shit, almost called the Popo.
They know they can't do this, Popo. This is okay. They know they can't do this.
Not too good to leave it here. Just get over here. Just get
down the toilet.
Nice pass.
Good pass.
Yep.
Damn.
Some good ass passing. Hell yeah. Oh, I came in late on that. Alright, we'll just keep the cameras rolling for the third piece of cash footage, just bonus, to make all my real life friends happy. That's what happens.
Why did the third quarter?
Oh, the third time I recorded the cash footage, and this time they missed it. Keep it rolling. Oh, because you're going to go home and watch out. You're probably more passionate about the NBA these days than I am. I used to be like that when I was younger, back when we were
young. Because the LeBron's still playing. When LeBron's not going to talk about the
same. I know. When Duncan retired. 38 seconds left. I just wanted it differently. He's gonna turn the ball over, maybe not. Oh, I got that on tape. Okay, the quality's better now. I don't know why it was like that. But like this, let me turn this back on for the second half. Easy. There we go.
Good.
Malachi Branham. I'm surprised you didn't get him based on the college you went to.
What kind of
Ohio State.
Oh, he is good. He's gonna be good.
Yeah. Well, he stays the real question. I don't know. I'm not like staying in San Antonio. Oh, he just started.
Yeah.
A lot of Cavs fans that follow on social media wanted him.
I don't know how to
show that. Right. I meant like they wanted him to draft him.
It's not like the
Cavs
could all win like $30 million.
Right. Oh, God! Yes! Oh! I think that was Barlow. Yeah. I noticed that Olivier Kelton was coming off the bench today.
He should be.
I know, he started like last year.
You can't have him air showing that they're not getting money to ball.
Right. Imagine this in 1997 where they were like Del Negro and Sean Elliott not passing to 10. Somebody made that analogy on Facebook. Avery Johnson, yeah, that too. I'm a Trey Jones fan, but he ain't it. I'm sorry. Avery Johnson light is what I would say.
He's on right there here, though, probably.
Third year.
Yeah, Avery was a veteran with some.
Avery was a veteran. Don't forget, Avery was on the Spurs the one time before Duncan was there. Even before Robinson was there, Avery. No, even before Robinson was there, Avery was on the team. Yeah, I looked it up. Oh yeah. Ah! Oh no, he missed it. Yeah, he did. you got 5 seconds, motherfucker. You gotta shoot. That's a good shot. Ooh, nice.
It missed, but that was good.
I didn't even know he was in foul trouble, Thompson. If he's number 12, then who took his original number?
Rubio had it.
He left.
He is
13. Yeah, but he can't change it like, per NBA rules. It's stupid.
They better retire Tristan Thompson jersey. They better LeBron jersey, Kevin Love.
They're retiring LeBron jersey in LA, which is tough.
Not that I don't like him. It's like he did. He should be in Cleveland, not Los Angeles. Yeah, LeBron won a championship. They retired Rivers. They retired Rivers.
He did more stuff in Cleveland than he did in Miami and Los Angeles combined.
LeBron won a championship.
He chose Jersey to retire. That's what happened. Yeah, they all have a huge impact on the team. Not in the world, do you want a championship or not? Whoa, it's a defense!
Smack it like Bobby Labonte.
Yeah. What now?
Dude, the referee failed with eyes so bad. Like,
well, they called a foul on Yas, so you should be happy.
I don't like
that
players are so out of control,
man. There's some players that played on our team in recent years that I didn't like either. So don't feel bad.
I don't like Caris LeVert. I don't like Jared Allen. Even though he's been hooping without Evan Mobley and Darius Garland.
We got those kind of players that just irked me for no reason on our team, too. I didn't like Pau Gasol in his late when he was here. Not the first year, in 16-17, but 17-18, he started to go down the toilet. Pau Gasol. I didn't like Aldridge. I didn't like Rudy Gay. I also didn't like Bryn Forbes, the second version of Bellinelli. And I didn't like Drew Eubanks. They all suck.
You don't love Bryn Forbes. But then he beat his baby mama or something.
Yeah, he beat his wife.
He's up NBA now. He's not in the NBA.
I know.
He's already about to be up NBA. Then he's really out now.
Yeah. Not only that, he...
Yeah, I like him.
2019-2020 season pre-COVID, he was bad. I mean, he did have some flashes of brilliance, but that was it. Like, the Martin Luther King game against Phoenix that we did win, on their territory, he did really well. But it was never consistent. The first version of Bellinelli was good, but you gotta admit the second version when he came back there, he did suck.
Oh, that's bad, oh my god!
I'm gonna shoot that first one! Oh! Bang! Bang! Tito Puente! No, they shared a lot. Oh, no, they almost did.
Oh, that's not enough.
Damn!
We're always
getting
steals. Eddie, come on!
Damn, come on, dude. Yeah!
What are you doing, bro?
I caught the tail end of that. Hell yeah. Here come the San Antonio Spurs. Even though the quality out sucks a little bit on this dude. I'm just shooting shit in. Hell yeah. Come on, dude. Donovan, you gotta get like 15, Mikey.
Yeah.
Oh, you gotta shoot that. What the fuck are you waiting for?
The defense, Donovan.
team need my energy. I'm going to turn up for the fourth quarter. I need my energy. I need my passion.
Game's over with.
Okay. That's shit.
I saw it. It hit off his foot. So I saw Hannah who it was.
I'm not happy about that one. Way off. Shit, now I'm missing it for
me. Camera's wobbly. Look at Wendy jumping on the roof like Rusty Wallace on the bend.
I'm gonna let you roll, bro.
Their Spurs players I did like because they were legitimately bad.
He's open!
Yeah. No, the players I did like the last several consecutive seasons were actually legitimately bad at costing this team and field, selling a lot of games that we could have won.
I got the same problem with the Lakers.
Yeah.
Yeah,
Trey Jones. Oh, he tried to go for the steal. Good effort.
Thanks for that.
Ooh. Get in there. Ah.
They're alive, dude. Only gave him that call. Oh, this is he got him good on the crossovers. That's the only reason he got that call.
That was a good ass crossovers.
It was.
You're gonna find different kinds of crash loaders in every sport.
You want soccer?
No. I just watch the best in NASCAR. They do that. They have crash loaders in NASCAR. They do that. Like when one car passes you, you go to the other, swing gun to the other side and you pass them back. Whoa, the fuck that was.
Here they are.
And yet you're the one who you don't like to either.
Except for the playoffs. That's all it is.
What did you do in the playoffs?
You got the 5 games to the Knicks, bro. You got Mr. Robinson and Julius Randle bullying him.
Wow.
And then, Mobley's younger. Mobley's only in his second year.
Except,
I'm not going to be. Jared Allen's been in the league for like 8 years.
So do you like Mobley's brother? Do you like him?
Yeah, he should be playing, I guess.
Yeah, Imani Bates, and I'm not against him, but I damn well think Imani Bates should be on the big name roster from the A. Yeah, this will be the last piece of footage I'll be recording on this camera because it's about to die, and then we're gonna record the rest of it on my phone. Ooh, that was close, I caught Petty. Oh, bang, bang, pizza, one thing. Now it's time to switch the phone for real.
All right, this is way better. Oh my God, we gotta work on that stupid ass camera. I'm not talking about the camera itself. It could be good quality. I'm talking about the quality. That quality sucks right now. All right, what's going on? Time out. Nice. Considering we almost grabbed them but gave them back up, and you guys got them back. I don't even know how long he's been in here. I thought he would have more. He could have hurt a lot. Well, I'm glad we gave him up because if he would have kept them, he would have took Patrick's number, and I would have been pissed.
Nice. I'll see you upstairs, bro.
All right. Hold on. I can't wait till Wemby shoots. I want to make sure I get this. And then you can get out. My dad wants to get a head start ahead of me to leave. I want to stay for the whole thing. Come on. Come on, lady. Get out the way. Come on, people, don't get the fucking way.
That was beautiful.
Hell yeah.
She got a little better angle. You should go over there a little bit more. The girl's in my way.
I zoomed it in even further. He made them both.
Superstar,
stop
giving him the ball.
Oh my God.
He's still a rookie.
This shit ain't over with yet.
Somebody behind you is holding me.
Yes.
Damn,
he's
going to be so good.
Sam Merrill.
Damn right. You got to stay healthy.
Stay hungry. Be easy. Like Neto Darius would say. Yes, yeah. Clutch free throws. Hell yeah. Oh my God, it's a 4-point game. We really about to win this shit. They're jumping. I got it, I'm getting it. Come on, Wemby. He's so tall. Just like the Bree Crane jump balls in Living La Vida Lambrex. That's at the beginning of the game with the Spurs and the Villains. Yeah! Two fucking points, baby. Let's fucking go. I know.
Do not lose this game.
Oh my God. I almost put on Facebook that the game is over. Defense. All of a sudden, my heart is pounding out of my chest.
That's all, dude.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Damn it! Oh my God.
Hey ho! Hey ho! Hey ho! Hey ho! You drew a picture of my morning, but you never make my day. I'm looking at you, but you never look my way. I'm looking down your darling in every single way. They got shit to do with shampoo to wash your head and shoulder. Brother, I'm another, you're another, you're my soldier. I'll read a minute of others when I say this. Put a music in the monkey bit. Niggas from the grill town, ill town. No matter how it feels now. There's a 90,000 sales town. You had the freestyle fans to be trying until we had them. Niggas with the view, niggas on vamping. I live in time for hip hop. I did with Bob the day. I licked up for hip hop. So hip hop, hooray! Oh, hey, oh, hey, oh. NBA Live 2000.
Refuse like Jeff Gordon.
What are you doing? Thank you, Scott Foster. Thank you.
First foul of number three, Kelvin Johnson. His third, first in the last 2 minutes.
First in the last 2 minutes. Going the other way.
Trying to flip everybody's camera.
This is fucking crazy. This is some good as shit.
Oh, we might miss one. How many times? Oh, you got one timeout left.
I don't give a shit who wins or loses at this point. This is fucking good ass shit. Yes. Awesome!
I don't even give a shit that we lost. That was amazing. It was a great game and an even better finish. And I hope that the one in San Antonio a week before Kelly Berglund's birthday and 2 weeks before mine is just as good. And even if it means we have to get another nail biter where my heart starts pounding out of my chest and my stomach is all in a knot and shit.
Later.
Post-game dinner after a hell of a game and even better finish? Why the fuck not?
Much later.
I wasn't expecting that dinner, nor was I expecting the game to be that close, but that does it for the annual Spurs Cavs vlog here in Ohio, as the tradition continues, and then we have until the 2024-2025 season to do it all again whenever the NBA decides to schedule it for whether it be the first half of the year or the second half. I like it better in the second half because, you know, it makes it, you know, more unique in its own way, like a different year. Which is why I kind of did not like the fact that they scheduled the 2014-15 meeting and the 2014 portion. It made no sense whatsoever. It would have actually been better, but, you know, based off, you know, me being a fan of trends and everything, if they would have put the one in San Antonio, the one where Kyrie scored 57 after the fraud could not make free throws, which was the second time in 3 seasons that he missed clutch free throws in like a crunch time where the Spurs could have won the game. Or the first one was even worse because it was for the championship and elimination game. But you know what I mean. That's a whole another tangent for another day. It would have been better to put that one in the slot where the one here took its place. Well, it would have been better to put that one in the slot that where the one here was that season, and the one that here that season to go in the place where the one in San Antonio was. But at the same time, it's the way they scheduled that was a blessing in disguise. Instead of them, like the one hell, you know, them scheduling it in reverse was a blessing in disguise because we still got to go to that game and do our Vegas trip for my 21st birthday all in one season. So that was a time that I'll never forget for as long as, there's a lot of times I'll never forget as long as I live, but that 2014-15 season when we spent the first half on Sandhurst finishing our time there, building the last of that legacy in that house to make the new transition here to what eventually became the happiest place in Northeast Ohio, was one hell of a time being a Spurs fan and an Austin and Ty Dillon fan before the extra drivers came starting in the summer of 2017 onward. But anyway, so therefore, here are the things I wanted to address before we wrap this all up, as my phone's getting ready to die. So therefore, we will not be going to work tomorrow. I just got to let my family know, warn them like Ward Burton, because I want to rest for the first half and work on this in the second half. And so yeah, my dad and I talked things out. I said, now that, you know, I'm almost 30, I want to, you know, from now on, plan, you know, do a better job of planning shit in advance, where if you want to schedule to do stuff with me, you have to, like, you know, talk to me first before you confirm it. So there's for, and luckily, I'm glad I opened up to them about this after discussing it with a lot of people, my mom, the people at ViaQuest that helped me. So therefore, we're taking baby steps. We're finally getting better at this. So therefore, so, what's the next video? Oh, shit. Okay, Tuesday, the Olive Garden Redemption for Ronald Gregory and Ezra Odota's birthdays. So, I don't know if we're going to record the Olive Garden part, but we're going to record that day. But we'll be lucky if we record the Olive Garden part. But Is it next Saturday? This coming Saturday, we're going to Braden Cole's game. You're going to see Angie for the first time since she, like, right before we had that mild cold was the last time we saw her, which was when you guys got robbed of a Sandy Ridge walk-off finale and a Friendsgiving video. Because, you know, I got screwed out of it myself and screwed out of bringing it to you guys. So, therefore, we're going to go on that tangent in the next video, which will be Tuesday's video. So, therefore, that's going to be the next video. That's going to be the next one. And then the next video after that, I don't know what we got, you know, after Braden's game. But the next Saturday after that, I mean, it depends on which Ridgeville games we decide to attend. I'm trying to go to at least 2 high school games. And 3 and 1 middle school game, which would be 3 for Earnhardt. That would work best for me. Now that my mom's no longer working at the clinic, so she's working from home now, sure she'll have more time to take me to these games whenever my dad don't want to. Because my dad is busier than my mom these days, now that, you know, it's a new life coming up with them, being split up compared to me, you know, compared to back when they were together many years ago. But anyway, so after the Braden Cole TV broadcast, we're going to bring you a YouTube doubleheader on the 20th. We got Poker Game Night, you know, season 3 premiere. Oh my God, I got to go to the bathroom so bad. Poker Game Night season 3 premiere. But before we do that, we're going to have Gavin McMullen's fifth grade basketball game. We're going to have the fifth grade basketball game in the afternoon. We're going to come home, edit it up, work on it, edit, upload that. And then we're going to go out and do the season 3 premiere of Poker Game Night. Except I have to make a new logo so I can differentiate the season, like to differentiate season 3 from season 2 and 1. After that, you know, perfect way to end season 2, I hope we can, you know, pick up where I left off and, you know, kick off season 3 in the same exciting fashion. And then the 27th, we got ourselves a haircut coming up. We got ourselves a haircut coming up, so that's going to be a good video. So, and then, of course, after that, the trip to San Antonio to see the Spurs play, in which the trip itself will be vlogged on this phone while we're going to put the game on this thing like we did today. So it's most likely the trip will be up before the game. The trip will be up before the game. And then the week after that, as long as I got the word from Christina, it is confirmed, as long as, you know, her kid's dad, you know, was able to take, you know, majority of the kids that she has to make enough room in the car for her, which is part of why, you know, our plans yesterday went down the toilet. We rescheduled to February 10th, a day after the Kelly Berglund birthday tribute. And yes, we're going to go see Jason play. I think it's a fourth grade basketball. And the Kelly Berglund birthday tribute, as always. And then I turn Jeff Green 30 years of age that following Thursday. And then Poker Game Night season 3, episode 2. And then the Daytona 500 and that possible small gathering for my Jeff Green 30th birthday for the Daytona 500. And you know damn well, as long as you know Mother Nature doesn't decide to be the bitchy-ass bitch that she always has been and always will be, and lets us fucking race since we're inviting people over for the 500 again for the first time since 2020. Man, I can't believe that was already 4 years ago. Then I will record our reactions to, like, what will most likely be a crazy finish, because after all, restrictor plate racing, including the Daytona 500, the biggest race of them all, like the NBA Finals is to basketball, or the World Series is to baseball, the Stanley Cup is to hockey, and X, Y, and Z. I'm not going to name that overhyped and overrated sport because fuck the NFL and everything it stands for, even though it's the season finale today, but I don't give a shit. I'm just happy. Give them credit for is that Cleveland and finally has something to celebrate in the sport of football. Then, you know, damn well, you know, as long as, you know, Mother Nature doesn't decide to intervene this time, like in 2020, the last time we invite people over the 500, at least we tried to. Unless you count 2021, where I had a bunch of surprise visitors for my birthday during the rain delay. You know, when the Spurs were playing the Hornets during the rain delay. And then by the time the rain, you know, by the time the game ended and the Spurs beat the Hornets, the race got bad going. Everybody left and my family went to bed. And if y'all remember that, that was another exciting time for me to be alive, being a NASCAR and a Spurs fan. But especially being a Ty Dillon fan who had, you know, who had lost his Germain racing ride due to them being, you know, laying too many people off and all this, how COVID, you know, like, fucked things up and affected it, a lot of shit in a big way. But yeah, but as long as, you know, Mother Nature doesn't intervene in like her bitchy ass self, or, you know, oh, like the bitchy ass bitch she's always has been and always will be, like in 2020, you know damn well we will record our finish. We will, everybody who's still at home and here at the house before the checker flag flies that day going into night, we're going to record a reaction to what will actually be a crazy ass finish, you know, based on, you know, what restrictor plate racing nowadays, it basically is. Daytona, Talladega, now Atlanta, including the biggest race of them all, which must be the NASCAR equivalent to the NBA Finals, the Stanley Cup, the World Series, and the NBA Finals, the Daytona 500. So have a good night tonight and a better day tomorrow. Take care, everyone. Good night. And I will see you all for that next video, whatever that may be. And win, lose, or tie, 27 years and counting, we'll see you all for the next version of this in San Antonio from February 2nd through the 4th, in hopes to meet Gabriella Graves, Nikki Hahn, and any of our, like, internet or TV friends that live down in the Texas area close to San Antonio. So, go Spurs, bitch. Oh, mama. See you later, everyone.
This copyrighted broadcast of the National Basketball Association may not be retransmitted, reproduced, rebroadcast, or otherwise distributed or used in any form without the express written consent of the NBA.